Hello and welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a simple and effective menu using CSS and HTML. It's going to work like this when we're done. I'm going to start from scratch and I'm going to use a tool like Notepad++. And you can see I'm starting out from nothing here. So I'm going to create an HTML tag, give myself some room, close that HTML tag. I'm going to head on up here, give myself a head tag, give myself some room, close that head tag. Then I'm going to do a body tag. Give myself some room and close that body tag. So now I've kind of got just a skeleton of what would be a web page. I guess this is probably a pretty good time to save my page. So I'm going to file, save as, and I'm going to call this demo2.html. I notice that by default it wants to save it as a text file. That's not going to work for me. I need to make sure that it is an HTML file. I'm calling it demo2, which is a horrible name, but it's too late now. Notice now I've got some syntax highlighting. This is good. In my head tag, I'm going to have a title tag. And this is going to be the title of my page, and I'll just call it demo. I'm going to close that title tag right there. And then I'm going to have my style tag. And this is where all my CSS is going to go eventually. And I'm going to close that style tag. My style tag's going to have a bunch of stuff in it. Now the body of my document is nothing more than an unordered list, and the tag for an unordered list is, guess what, UL. All right, so I create my list, and I close my list, and my list is going to be filled up with list items. All right, so that's an LI tag, and I'm going to just close that right there, and so whatever goes between there is what's going to show up as the list item. And I believe I had something like homepage displayed. My next list item. I think I had some text like page 2, close the list item, and I had a third list item, which was page 3. All right, so now we've got a baseline, and so let's see what this looks like. So if I save this, Control S, I'm going to open this up in Firefox. You'll see what I've got, a bolded list, right? That looks goofy. They're not links. I need to make them links. So there's always a balance between explaining things and taking too long and just not explaining anything and finishing in 5 minutes. I'm going to try and walk the line between both of those. I'm going to create an anchor tag, and I'm going to set the href attribute to a pound sign, which is a good way of writing a dummy link that doesn't go anywhere. It's going to behave like a link, and I'm going to style it like a link, but it's not really a link that does anything particularly. I've done enough of these today where I'm just getting worse at this point, but I'm trying to make this with no mistakes, and that looks pretty clean to me. Syntax highlighting is kind of telling me I think I set that up right. So now I can save this and I can preview it, and I've got a list full of links, and it looks pretty goofy, and really, so we're going to use CSS to make this look pretty. So heading back on over to Notepad. I'm going to go up here and I'm going to do this the easiest way that I know how, and I'm just going to redefine some tags. So I'm going to redefine all list items. So I do that like this. So I want to redefine the LI tag, sorry, LI, curly braces, and everything I do in here is going to apply to list items. So one of the things that I want is I want to get rid of these bullets. All right, so that is list style type. And I want none, and that equal sign is none. So if I do that and I save this and I refresh this, I've now gotten rid of the bullets, which is actually a pretty big step towards getting this thing looking decent. Another thing I want to do is I want to set the width to 125 pixels. I've just done this before. That's saying that I don't want these to take up my entire screen, because by default these elements are going to be the width of my screen, which is not what I want. And I'm also going to set the background color to a hex value, and I'm going to go with ABC, which is just kind of a nice light blue color. And if I refresh, you can see that I did something wrong. My guess is going to be they spelled background wrong. Sorry about that. Funny how one little character can mess things up. It was only affecting one attribute, but now you can kind of see some things happening. So some other stuff that I want to do before we move on is I'm going to center that text. And that text is, that's the text align property. And I want it to be centered. And now we go preview, and now we're looking okay. The thing that looks really dumb about this right now is I've got underlines underneath my text, which is kind of goofy. I would also like to point out how if I'm on the side of my list, you would think that this should be a link. Right here, this should link me to homepage, and this should link me to page 3. But right now, you have to browse over the text. We're going to address all that right now. So the other thing I want to define here is I want to define all of the links that are within my list. And that's how I write that out. I'd say every anchor tag, which is within a list, I want to do some things to it. One of the things I want to do is get rid of the text decoration. Now this, if I set this to none, then that is what gets rid of the underlines, which is a pretty big step for us. Another thing that I want to do is I want these to display as block elements. All right, this is also a big one, and this is another thing that I was just referring to. So I do this, I refresh, nothing happens, except for now it's going to be treated like a button instead of some text, right? It is just text, but now the link is the entire list item itself, not just the text, which is a big deal. And the last thing we're going to do to fancy this guy up is I'm going to say all anchor tags within inside of my list, I'm going to set their hover attribute. All right, so this means when I hover over it, if you remember my thing I showed you in the beginning, when you hovered over them, the background color was turning to brown. So that's going to be background color, and I did brown, so I'm just going to write brown. And the other thing I did is I made the text color yellow. So that's not text color, that's just color, which is kind of misleading. You might think it does something else. But if you just write color, that means text color. I save, I head on over here, nothing happens. But now when I hover over my links, they change colors. And this is good because the user can actually tell what's going on. Now there's one more thing I had in my final example, and that was this underline on the bottom of every element. So let's do that real quick. So for list items, I want a border, and it was just on the bottom of the every item. And so I'm gonna say 2 pixels is what that was. It was solid and it was black. So kind of a weird set of things. This is the width of the border. This is the type of border. This is the color of the border. This indicates that there's only a border on the bottom. So if I save this and give it a preview, you can see this is the menu that I started off with. And that only took us about, hard to say because I spent a lot of time just talking. But you can see with relatively little code, we've created a menu that is both functional and it looks decent. And you could do whatever you wanted with this. You could make all kinds of improvements, but just as far as bare minimum list, this should get the job done. Hopefully this helps you guys get started developing some web pages and creating some navigation menus. Thanks for watching.